Today I'm gonna explain the major difference between a nutrition coach and a nutritionist. So if you're considering either career path, you know which one is the right move for you. Plus, tell you some insider only nutrition coaching secrets so you can avoid making big mistakes that could ruin your nutrition business. Here's what you need to know. First off, nutrition coaches are changing the world. And it has a lot to do with how they operate and interact with clients, which I'm going to detail in full later in this video. But if you're wondering the main difference between a nutritionist and a nutrition coach, I don't blame you. There's a lot of confusion. What you need to understand is this: neither nutritionist or nutrition coach is a protected term. And the path to get to either of those can vary from person to person and how they want to help clients. And anyone can call themselves either of those terms, which is different from registered dietitian or registered dietitian nutritionist, which is a protected term by government bodies. These professionals are different in the sense that they help manage the diets of people with known medical conditions or diseases. The people in these roles know exactly who they are, and they're probably not watching this video. But for you, the person that's passionate about nutrition or health and wanting to help others in the same way, you may be wondering what path to go down. And here's the basic difference. A nutritionist is typically a certified professional who instructs people how to eat, but there isn't one specific certification to get there. And they can vary quite a bit in both their length, commitment, and how they operate as nutritionists, and quite frankly, their credibility. Whereas a nutrition coach doesn't necessarily need a certification, but a credible one is usually a good start. But they teach and coach clients how to eat towards a specific client-chosen goal. And since I know this area very well after being an online nutrition coach for 12 years and training and certifying hundreds of other nutrition coaches, here's what I know to be the biggest difference between nutritionists and nutrition coaches. Again, I've taught hundreds of nutrition coaches over the last decade and been surrounded by even more. And there's one common trait that unites them all, and that is passion. These are the people that firsthand know the importance of nutrition through a massive personal transformation, or witnessing the impact that nutrition had on coming back from an injury, or elevating sports performance to the next level. But seriously, after a decade as a nutrition coach, I still haven't come across another nutrition coach that wasn't completely fueled by passion. While other nutrition professionals, like nutritionists, can be passionate, of course, there's something different about those in the nutrition coaching space. They are the ones that we'll be working with people with or without pay, although they know the former works better for everyone, because nutrition and fitness has made the difference in their lives. So it only makes sense to pass that along to others. And if you're passionate about nutrition and wellness and love helping others, then nutrition coaching might be the right move for you too. So passion is the common denominator here for all nutrition coaches. But there's another thing that sets them apart from other nutrition professionals, and it's the way that they carry out their business. It's the coaching aspect. See, although that nutrition coaches and nutritionists have a fundamental understanding of the science of nutrition, a nutritionist tends to provide this advice in the moment. And it can just stop there, but this isn't how coaching works. A nutrition coach helps transform people through accountability and guidance and direction through time. When you have a goal, a nutrition coach guides you through what holds you back from reaching it, a science-based plan including calories, macronutrients, and food choices, what adjustments to make depending on results, barriers from sticking to your plan, and provides accountability and guidance as you move towards your goal. And this is how coaching works. Think about it this way. If I want to get better at basketball, I wouldn't just talk to someone about the theory of basketball. I'd join a team with a coach and go to practices and plan games and get feedback and tell them all about my goals and learn and apply what I need to get to the next level. And they would help me through time in a structured way to get there. This is how coaching works. And where many nutritionists miss the boat is that they don't have a coaching system that is conducive to doing this. It's usually based on an outdated in-person counseling setup that's run session by session. And that's not how nutrition coaches do things. Now, I do want to paint a clearer picture around who a nutrition coach should be working with, because at worst, and I really mean this, not knowing this can really ruin a nutrition coach's business as well as the health of their clients. And at minimum, cause a lot of frustration. And quick sidebar, depending on where you are in the world, your country, and even your state or provincial or territorial guidelines can be different, but this is the basic premise. These are the type of clients that a nutrition coach should be working with. Since the main role of a nutrition coach is to help people improve their lives through nutrition and behavior change in ways that they could do themselves, but a nutrition coach just helps them do that faster and more effectively and safely, nutrition coaches are best suited and qualified to help people in the following areas: changes in body composition, like losing weight and losing fat and even gaining muscle, athletic and training performance, as well as improvements in overall health, like improved energy and mental clarity, as well as sleep and overall vitality. with the intent to cure or manage that disease. And that last part is important, so let me go over it again. Just because someone has a known medical diagnosis doesn't mean you can't work with them as a nutrition coach, as long as you're not giving them recommendations to manage that disease. For example, if someone has Crohn's disease, which is a chronic bowel disease, and they want to lose weight, if they have that disease controlled and you feel comfortable working with them to lose weight, you can do that. But your recommendations don't extend to the management of the Crohn's disease. Think of it this way. If you could refer to the person that you're working with as a patient and not a client, you shouldn't be working with them as a nutrition coach. This is what's best for the client, but it's also what's best for the nutrition coach. There's someone else that is better suited to help them. And this will ultimately save you time and frustration and even money, focusing your energy on the people that you should be working with. One thing I do want to point out is that in the event that someone that is in this situation comes to you and applies to work with you or DMs you and shouldn't be working with you, it doesn't mean that you drop them like a bad habit and never talk to them again. That's pretty unethical if you ask me. Just because you shouldn't help them in a paid coaching relationship doesn't mean you can't refer them to someone more helpful and help get them there. You just don't give them specific advice or take their money. In the Dr. Marc Method Nutrition Coaching Certification, we teach a framework on when to refer out, so our students know more about who they shouldn't work with so they can focus all their energy on who they should be working with. Because when you focus your energy on your ideal perfect fit clients, it provides better outcomes and results for the clients, and it's better for your business too. Learning about chronic disease and the patient specific advice required to manage them can be interesting, but it's impossible to scale up. You'll spend more time learning than problem solving and be sent so far down the rabbit hole that you won't be able to help more people in the way that you're supposed to be helping them. This isn't a good situation for anyone, and you need to double down on the people that you should be working with and avoid the ones that you shouldn't. And this is gonna be good news for your nutrition coaching business and the industry as a whole. And the last point I wanna highlight is the part around specific advice. Nutrition coaches show and teach their clients how to eat, but what they don't do is give them exactly what to eat, meaning they don't give meal plans, because that's what can get you in trouble. Because if you tell someone exactly what to eat and they run into issues, you will be liable. This is the issue that fitness influencer Brittany Dawn Davis found herself in when prescribing exact meal plans to a vulnerable clientele. What you do instead as a nutrition coach is teach people how to eat on an individual level and give suggestions and build habits within this structure. You could even provide sample meal plans as inspiration, but it's not eat exactly this. Nutrition coaching has exploded and it continues to grow because when the science of nutrition meets effective coaching, clients can finally focus on the things that matter the most, build habits that last, and create results that they're happily willing to pay for. There are some major differences between this and the nutritionist space, so I hope you found this video helpful. As great as all these tips are, if you're really serious about starting a nutrition coaching business, the next thing I'll have you do is check out this video I've linked up right here on how to start a nutrition coaching business from scratch and get your first 5 paying clients. So make sure to check it out now, and I'll see you in the next video.